Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released iOS 17.5 Beta 4. iOS 17.5 Beta 4 is out to developers and soon to public beta testers. Typically by the time you're watching this video it will release, or the following day. Now this update came in at 529.4 megabytes on the 15 Pro Max and was about the same size on all the devices we have here, just over 500 megabytes or so. Along with this, Apple also released iPadOS 17.5 Beta 4, WatchOS 10.5 Beta 4, along with tvOS and HomePodOS 17.5 Beta 4, macOS 14.5 Beta 4, and visionOS 1.2 Beta 4. There's also updates for the Mac on older devices as well. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the build number and talk about what's new. So we'll go to Settings, then we'll go down to General, then About. As you can see, the build number is 21F5073B. As we get closer to a final release, the letter at the end gets closer to the letter A, letting us know it's almost out. Now, as far as what's new in this update, well, there is no modem update in iOS 17.5 Beta 4. So if you're going from Beta 3 to Beta 4, you won't have an update there. However, one thing I wanted to mention is with iPadOS, it's now seen as a gatekeeper device, with the operating system being similar to iOS, meaning that it must allow sideloading in third-party app stores in the EU. This is something that the EU just gave Apple a ruling to do, and they have 6 months to actually comply with that change. And then shortly after this announcement, Epic Games said they'll be bringing Fortnite to iPad. So as soon as that's available, I'm sure we'll see that only in the European Union at this point. Hopefully Apple brings it elsewhere. Now, a few things I wanted to mention as far as what's new is there is mentions of a new repair mode in the OS. We've seen mentions of this before, but it looks like it's there when you try and disable Find My. Maybe it won't disable it entirely, but can ask you if you want to go into a repair mode. Also, we have some wording changes for screen time. So this is going to be more of a refinement update, but if we go into screen time and maybe we go to beta 3 here on the device on the left, you'll see it before on the left, it said set limits based on contacts under communication limits. On the right with beta 4, it says set limits for calling and messaging. Again, like I said, this is more of a refinement update as we get closer to a final release. We know the different features that are already contained herein, and things such as settings, where we have a new setting such as beta 3, where under news, we have a new option for Game Center. We have some new puzzles here. Under books, we have a new status for the actual amount of reading we've done. So you'll see here for our reading goals, you have that at the top. So little refinements here and there, along with the podcast widget that changes based on what's playing. If I press play on the widget with the waveform podcast, you'll see the widget actually changes for podcasts and matches the album art. So that's something that's new, but this is more of a refinement update as iOS 18 will bring all of the big changes. We did have an app update today with iMovie, and that's the first time in quite some time, with improved access to replacing and editing clips in Magic Movie and Storyboard projects. They fixed some issues with editing clips and included stability and performance improvements. So some nice updates there. Also, we got the release of Beats Solo 4. So if you've wanted some new Beats, those are available now. You can get them in Apple Store, or if we just go to Apple here, we have Beats Solo 4 for $199.99, and they also announced Beats Solo Buds coming in June. Everything else is being saved for iOS 18, where we expect major redesigns, so it makes a lot of sense that they wouldn't put a ton of effort into the apps here, as they're going to redesign things such as fitness and notes, maybe some changes with weather or photos. We don't really know the entire story just yet, but it looks like there's going to be such big changes that I wouldn't suspect that we would have too much new in iOS 17 at this point. So we really know what's in iOS 17.5, but as far as any other major changes, expect that in a few weeks with iOS 18 when they release beta 1. With Apple's upcoming Let Loose event, where we expect new iPads, maybe a new Apple Pencil and some changes there, Apple has updated their newsroom webpage to show a countdown to that actual event. You can add it to the calendar here and you'll see we're about 6 days and 19 hours away. So that's when we expect all the major announcements. And then of course, iOS 17.5 will probably contain all of the things needed for this, as we've seen that in the code, with mentions of maybe a squeeze gesture for the Apple Pencil coming to iOS 17.5. Apple has still not added the stopwatch live activity in iOS 17.5. So at this point, I don't think they're going to do that for whatever reason. Of course, it works for timers and other things, but just not the stopwatch anymore. Why they don't add that back, I'm not sure. But maybe again, they're redoing something with the clock app for iOS 18. We still don't have SharePlay for HomePod and Apple TV as well. However, this update does fix some bugs. Apple actually announced that they're going to be fixing an issue soon where they're working on a fix for the alarm clock issue. So that's something I've mentioned in previous updates where sometimes you have an alarm set and it doesn't go off. It should go off and sound the alarm, but at this point it's not doing that for many people. Apple has actually told Joanna Stern at the Wall Street Journal that Apple's working on a fix for this update. So we could have something coming very soon. We don't really know that 100%. It could be an iOS 17.5 or another release. So we could see iOS 17.4.2 maybe in a few days to next week. And then of course, Apple will continue with iOS 17.5. As far as bug fixes, well, there's no known issues in the release notes. If we go into the feedback app, and if we go into the recent release notes, and they're available on the public facing website as well, you'll see we have resolved issues for accessibility, resolved issues for app tracking transparency, new features with Core Motion, the new eSIM feature I mentioned last week, as well as resolved issues for StoreKit and Wallpaper. All of those things are resolved. There are no known issues here listed at all. So that's a great sign. However, it also seems that they've fixed the wallpaper dimming bug for the most part, but not for everything. So if we go into wallpaper here and slide up, it does seem to dim if the wallpaper is very saturated. However, if it's a different wallpaper with less saturation, it seems that they've sort of fixed it. If we go over to standby mode, they haven't fixed this yet either. So if we go ahead and lock the screen, wait for standby to turn on, give it just a moment, we can't press and hold to edit anymore. So once you've edited this, you can't change it. And we're still not sure why Apple hasn't fixed this yet, but this is a long-standing bug, it seems at this point, this late in betas, that we haven't seen it fixed. So I'm not sure why they haven't done that. Hopefully by the time it's released to the public, it will be resolved. Of course, we do expect security updates in this update, but we won't know about those until the day it releases, as Apple updates their Apple security website. In the Apple security release website, they'll have this updated usually the day it releases to the public. I wish they would give us more details ahead of time, but that could pose a security risk, and maybe that's why they don't do that. Performance-wise, the overall update seems to be pretty good, with one exception. As I scroll through, you'll see that ProMotion is nice and fast, and it seems to be a similar experience with iPhone 11 that's also on beta 4. So if I go to the app library, of course we don't have ProMotion here, but it's nice and smooth as far as what these devices can do. If we go into music, it loads nice and fast. Go to browse, of course that's loading off Wi-Fi, but you have a very similar experience. But the keyboard seems to be a little bit laggy for me. Now that might be because it's processing a lot in the background, but for the most part it seems to be okay, but then sometimes you'll just type maybe iMovie, and it will lag. In fact, it will lag so bad sometimes that it doesn't show up for a couple of seconds, then it types everything. So I'm not sure if, again, this is something it's just processing in the background and slowing things down, or if we have a problem here and they still need to fix it. Heat of the device seems to be fine. Right after reinstalling an update or installing an update, it's going to be a bit warm, but it's not overly warm. And after a few days of processing, I'm sure it will actually settle down, but we'll measure that in the weekend follow-up video. Battery life, I'm not really sure about, as that's going to take a few days, but let's take a look at battery health. And you'll see I'm down to 98% with 172 cycles. This is pretty typical compared to what I've seen from many other people that have sent me what their battery health is, and it seems to be right on track. Battery life itself has not been great for me with the previous betas. So 3 hours and 11 minutes of screen active time, 5 hours and 44 minutes of screen idle time, and I used over 75% of my battery yesterday. Today I have 2 hours and 21 minutes of screen active time, and I'm down to 61%. That's still including installing this update. So it's doing better today, but still not great, and hopefully it greatly improves. You can see that YouTube took up quite a bit of power, as well as home and lock screen and some other things. But for the most part, it just hasn't been great for a long time. That's mostly the fault of iOS, not so much the phone though. And if you're wondering if you should install iOS 17.5 beta 4, if you're on beta 3, keep going with the betas and provide feedback to Apple, as that's how they test things and fix bugs based on priority. But if you're not on the betas yet, I'd hold off until Apple releases iOS 17.4.2 or maybe 17.5 in a few weeks. And as far as when to expect the next update, well, we're on a weekly schedule, and we could expect iOS 17.5 RC or release candidate probably the day that the Let Loose Apple event takes place on May 7th. So based off of what we usually have, we would have the release candidate after that event with all of the code for the new iPads and Apple Pencil included, and then a final release of this update, iOS 17.5, on the 13th or 14th. Apple could change this up and release it in a few days after the event, but usually that's the sort of release schedule they have. In between that, like I said, we could see iOS 17.4.2 and then all of the major changes with iOS 18 Beta 1 on June 10th after the event. That's where Apple's really supposedly going to have a huge update with iOS 18. So that's what I'm looking most forward to. Now, I did run benchmarks to see what they're like. You'll see I scored 2,894 for single core, 7,219 for multi-core. Given that this was probably 30 minutes after installing the update, that's pretty good. It's better for multi-core and about the same for single core. So 2 points lower for single core than the previous beta, but overall quite good. So no issues there. So at this point, there's not a whole lot more to talk about with iOS 17.5. We'll wait for the next event, and then hopefully we'll get a longer list of things they've fixed as far as features and more. Let me know if you've found anything else in iOS 17.5 Beta 4 in the comments below, and of course I'll link this wallpaper in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe, and if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.